Good morning, Sheila. How are you this morning?
Wayne, I'm very good. How are you this morning?
You know, I'm doing pretty well. And I understand that we need to, yes, push through this because there are things to be done, people to see. Yes.
Yeah, busy day, but we always enjoy taking time out to do this podcast.
Absolutely. And welcome to our listeners and to everyone from 27 Minutes with Sheila and Wayne, where we explore the fascinating world of verbs and their impact on our daily lives. Join us each week as we delve into the different ways verbs shape our language and influence our interactions as we attempt to make a positive difference in our world, one verb at a time.
Right.
And Sheila, what is our verb for today?
Today's verb is to offer. I have two definitions and then a challenge of sorts, or a challenge I experienced. So, okay. But let's heading to the definitions first, the two definitions I have, and then the summary is to present something or someone or oneself for acceptance or rejection. Hmm. Number two is to propose or put forward for consideration. And number three is to agree to give. So I had said two, but I meant three.
Okay.
Okay. How about yourself?
All right. You offered us a third one. I understand. Yes.
Yes.
Okay. All right. I have to ask someone if they would like something or if they would like you to do something.
Okay.
I've got to say a prayer or make a sacrifice. Another one. I have four more.
Okay. Wow.
To provide or supply something. To say officially that you would like to buy something, especially a house or a car at a particular price.
Right.
To make shares, et cetera, available for sale. You probably know something about that.
I do. I'm quite the shopper, as it turns out.
And the last one, to provide or have particular features or advantages.
All right.
And I like all of those.
I do too.
And Sheila, where can our audience find you?
Why, thank you. My email address is zekeandsheila@yahoo.com.
Aha. And my email address is wayne@mindsyncing.com. And my website is mindsyncing.com. That's mindsyncing.com.
Thank you, Wayne.
Yeah, well, thank you, Sheila. And
so,
as always,
I just wanted to say, I appreciate positive feedback, any negative feedback, and that goes to Wayne's email address.
That's right. I take all the negatives. That's good. Yes.
Well, you know, actually, one thing I learned about to offer is often it's meant in a polite way. And so what I just said was not polite. It was poor etiquette, and I apologize to you.
No, but it was polite because, yes, you don't want, yeah, I understand. If it's polite, you said, hey, please don't give it to me. Give it to Wayne.
Please offer up that feedback to Wayne.
Yes.
So here's the challenge that I ran into with this verb, and that is that I kept wanting to slide into the noun offer as a noun instead of using offer as a verb. And on the surface, you'd say, well, what's the big deal? So my husband and I were talking about it. He said, well, there's a real estate offer. You make an offer on a house. I said, no, that's a noun. Well, in finance, you tender an offer. No, an offer is a noun. So if you're using to before it, it's a verb. If you're using an or the before it, it's a noun.
It's a noun.
So sometimes as I was researching it, I kept sliding into using it as a noun instead of as a verb.
Okay.
but I did start by looking up all the headlines, just jotting down all the headlines related to offer. And would you like to hear some of them?
Absolutely.
I thought you might. The first one is Ford will soon offer a digital license plate to its customers. And I thought, well, what's the advantage of a digital license plate? And by the way, you can get it for a mere $599 with an annual service plan of $75 a year. So what in the heck is the benefit of a digital license plate? And then the first thing they said it was good for was if you like a monochromatic look so it matches your car paint color. I thought, I'm not paying that much to get a monochromatic look. I'm not paying to get it in light or dark mode. You don't need that. However, its renewal can be automatic. You don't need a registration sticker. You can pay extra and get GPS, mileage tracking, or stolen vehicle alerts. And as it turns out, a lot of companies use these for their fleets, and those uses make a lot of sense. You can also have customizable banner messages on it. And I thought, I've always wanted a customizable banner message to say things like, stop tailgating me, or you missed your turn, ha ha ha.
Or eat at Joe's.
Eat at Joe's. But in this day and age, probably it's not good to engage with other drivers in any way that may let them feel they're being criticized, because they may not respond very well.
You know, and it's so sad that you say that, but it's absolutely true.
Yep. I won't be buying a digital license plate anytime soon.
Okay, but I did like the one about you don't have to have a sticker.
Right, and it automatically renews. Yes.
And how did the police know that as they're driving behind you, looking at your license plate?
I'm guessing in order, and by the way, these are legal in all of the states in the U.S., And the fact that fleets have been using for a while, maybe there's a reader, you know, like a radar reader or something that alerts them to it being, up to date.
Yes. Okay. And speaking of license plates and fleets, because a fleet is a large body of something.
Vehicles. Boats,
vehicles. Oh. What have
fish.
You?
Okay.
Fish. I think that's a school, but it's okay.
Yeah, that's true.
You're a scuba diver, but I was talking to my son maybe a couple of weeks ago. He was in the car with me, and I was driving down the road, and all of a sudden something passed me, and I said, "Hey, do you know that vehicle and vehicles that belong to that fleet don't have to have license plates?"
Oh,
I said, "Do you see a license plate on that vehicle?" And he goes, "No." I said, "None of them have license plates."
Maybe they had digital license plates.
No, those are postal vehicles.
Oh, government postal vehicles.
The USPS is the only fleet of vehicles that do not have to have license plates.
I have just learned something new. Thank you.
Yes. So everybody who's saying nay, Google that and see if U.S. postal vehicles have license plates. The answer is they do not.
That's almost a trivia question.
It is. Well, I would offer that up as one, but
I got another couple of headlines, but I won't dive deep into these like I did that first one.
Okay. All right.
Costco is the latest retailer to offer doctor visits via online partnership with a company called Sesame. Uh-huh. The next one is this from the Society of Human Resource Management. The headline was, "Are we required to offer benefits to part-time employees?" And in case you wanted to know, the answer is if you have 50 or more employees and the employee works more than 30 hours a week, then yes, you are required.
Really?
Another headline was 92% of consumers look for a deal when shopping. And so offering discounts is very well received by consumers. Hmm. The next one was how to use a job offer to negotiate a higher salary where you are.
Aha. Uh-huh.
Thought that was interesting. Then I've got some other paths I went down, but let me stop right there and see where you headed down with this verb.
I jumped in just like you did. I jumped right into the internet and I said, okay, let me see what pops up.
Okay.
After I had obviously went to the dictionaries. And what popped up continuously was legal terms. Like contract law, as what constitutes an offer, with the emphasis on contract law, or what is the difference between an offer and a proposal, or what is the difference between an offer and a suggestion? And I said, I don't want to go down the legal thing. This is a fun podcast. We are. We're looking at verbs. We're looking at verbs that are going to excite individuals and that we can see from different perspectives. I don't want to go down this linear track of law. No, contract law stuff. No. So I said, I've got to find something else. And then I thought, there must be something different. So I went back to my usual self. I said, okay, let me see if I can come up with a professional and a personal listing of how I have heard offer and see if that comes up and changes the way that I can focus on this verb. And guess what?
You found some.
Eureka. And I will offer that. I will offer that to our audience today.
Good.
Yes.
Okay.
All right. So I started with personal. And on my personal list, I said, hey, we tend to offer to take someone out to dinner or lunch. Mm-hmm. Okay. We offered to give someone a ride. Mm-hmm. And I said, okay. Offered to pick someone up from the airport, bus, or train station. Mm-hmm. Yes, we do that. Offer to make dinner for someone.
Oh, all of these sound lovely.
You know, and I'm glad you said that because I have something coming up.
Okay.
Offer to cut a person's lawn.
Oh, nice.
And I said, huh. And then I thought, wow, how about a random act of kindness? Because offer to do something to or for a stranger is putting a smile on my face as I'm thinking about this. So I said, huh, how about opening an offer to open a door for an elderly or handicapped person or for someone struggling with bulky items as they're mm-hmm. going into the post office?
Good idea.
Or coming out of the post office with bulky items.
Yep.
And I thought, well, how about this one? Offer to, now I'm sure not everybody who's listening is going to do this one, but
okay.
Offer to wash your neighbor's car while you're washing yours.
That's very kind.
I might hose them down with the hose, but I don't know if
the neighbor or the neighbor's car.
Well, okay, I'm not going to say.
Okay, all right, just clarifying.
How about this? Because I've done this, and my next door neighbor does this to us as well. Shovel your neighbor's sidewalk while you are shoveling yours.
Yes, from snow, in case you're living in the South and you aren't sure what that means.
Well, that's true. Yes. And I have lived there, so I know what that means. So, okay.
Okay.
I
won't, all right.
But we won't go there. How about make an extra batch of cookies and offer it to your neighbor or a friend?
Nice.
And then I thought, these are genuine acts of kindness. Mm-hmm. And I wonder, which you have already kind of related to, which led me to an article, The Art of Kindness.
Oh, I like it already.
Yes, by Dr. Steve Siegel. And I will stop there because I'll go back to you, but then I'll come back and I'll tell you what Dr. Siegel has said about the art of kindness.
Okay. Well, I have a couple quotes I would like to offer up.
We like quotes.
Okay. This one is Lady Gaga, an American musician and songstress. Music is one of the most powerful things the world has to offer. No matter what race or religion or nationality or sexual orientation or gender that you are, it has the power to unite us.
Huh.
So I thought that was, and I have to tell you, one time I was Black Friday shopping, which means everyone in the world is going shopping the Friday after Thanksgiving because supposedly you get wonderful deals. And the line for the cash register snaked all the way around this store.
Oh, no.
One song came on the radio and almost everybody was dancing in place in their line.
Really?
To that song, or at least swaying a little bit.
What was the song?
I can't even remember. It was maybe a Backstreet Boys song.
Okay.
So I could see the unity that she described in that experience. Okay, here's George Washington, our first president, said, "It's better to offer no excuse than a bad one."
Ah, okay.
I'm not sure how that came up in conversation, but there it was. Now, Julia Child, I don't so much identify with this, but she was quite the amazing chef. And she said, someone may offer you a freshly caught whole large fish, like a salmon or a striped bass. Don't panic. Take it. I'm not sure I'm going to follow that advice.
Yeah, I don't know. Yeah. Yes.
And then finally, Zig Ziglar said, I took up an offer for me to lose 30 pounds in 30 days, and it worked. I lost 30 days. He's a motivational speaker. So I like
that. I have to tell you, once I was on an airplane flying, and I don't remember where, to or fro, I have no idea. However, I took with me a couple of sheets of paper.
Okay.
And actually, it was more than a couple. I took a lot of sheets of paper because it happened to be Christmas Eve.
Oh.
And since I celebrate Christmas, and it was one of those fun flights. It was on Southwest.
Oh.
And so I asked the flight attendant, I said, hey, it's Christmas Eve. If there are individuals on this plane who would like to sing Christmas carols, do you think we could do that? And she said, well, you know, there's probably individuals who have, there's probably a smattering of religions on the plane and some who maybe not have any religious ties. So that may not be good. But she says, but a few people around you, if they didn't mind, maybe they might sing. And some overheard what we were talking about. And this guy goes, hey, I'll sing. And I heard a lady say, I'll sing. And then a person behind me goes, what are we singing? And so I offered the sheets to them and we sang a couple Christmas carols and we got an applause. Yay.
Oh, yay.
Yes. Which leads me into the article by Steve Siegel.
Yes, let's hear Steve's article.
The Art of Kindness. And he says, kindness is more than behavior. The art of kindness involves harboring a spirit of helpfulness, mm-hmm. being generous and considerate, and doing so without expecting anything in return. Mm-hmm. And I thought, you know what? That is so true. Because mm-hmm. when you offered to open the door for a stranger, you have mm-hmm. no idea who the person is, and you're not expecting anything in return for that. No?
That's right. Right. Yes.
Okay. He went further, and this is where I was very happy that I stumbled upon this article because it did not go through any linear lines of, oh, we've got to have a contract, and we've got to do this, and what's a contract, and how do you make an offer, and how do you refuse an offer of employment via email? And I'm thinking, you know, those are so boring. But I mean, good information, but, you know, that wasn't what I was looking for. He says, rather than viewing it exclusively as an action, think of kindness as a quality of being you that you can cultivate. Giving kindness often is simple, free, and health enhancing. And I thought, okay, tell me more. He says it's good for the body. He says kindness has been shown to increase self-esteem, empathy, and compassion, and improve mood. And I can't disagree with that because mm-hmm. many times when I've offered to help people, I feel good about myself.
Yeah.
A smile comes to me and they typically smile. Now, I've had some who didn't smile.
Right.
But they typically smile and say thank you. And I feel that, you know, I would not have had that cordial exchange with anyone unless I did that. Mm-hmm. And so what Steve was saying was pretty good. He says it's good for the mind, too. Because he says psychologically, kindness can positively change your brain by boosting levels of serotonin.
We love those hormones, those happy brain hormones.
And you talked to us about dopamine last time. And I'm thinking, you know what? This is just reeling into that mode or that operanda that Sheila has espoused so many times. And I'm thinking, this is just fun. This is good. Yes. So offer. And again, I will defer to you because I could go on and on, but I will stop with those 2 points. And I have 3 more that he said.
Okay. Then I'm going to just jump in and say that I found that the verb to offer does have a certain measure of agreeableness and politeness and positivity about it. Mm. Because oftentimes, especially on a personal level, I'm not so much talking about the business applications, but when you're offering someone to somebody, often it's because they're a guest. Would you like a drink? Can I get you something? Are you up for something? It's an unoffensive word. It's it generally calls for a similar polite response. Oh, thank you so much, but I'm on a diet or whatever. And then that reminded me of when you're talking to someone and you need to end the conversation, they recommend it kind of fits in with the guidelines of using the etiquette. Positive etiquette around to offer. And I learned this, it's called sweet, sour, and sweet. And I might even have referenced it already on a podcast.
Okay.
And it's, you say something nice, then you say that you have to leave. You give the good news, bad news, and then another good news. So you give a sweet message, the sour message, and the sweet message. So for instance, yes, thank you. I'd love a cup of tea, but I'm late for a meeting. Can I take a rain check?
Ah.
Sweet, sour, and sweet.
Sweet, yes.
So it's a good way of turning someone down or of ending a conversation. Yes.
And you have mentioned that before.
I thought so.
You did.
And I won't do it again because then it gets boring.
No, but it's very apropos. I like it. I do.
Well, let's hear what else Steve has to say about it.
Well, he says that we can discover ways that we can change or create happiness. And then he said something that really impacted me, because I heard another person say this too. I was at a conference once, and Terry Bradshaw, the football player, I like him a lot, but he said the same. He said it a little bit different than what Steve is saying. Steve says, be kind to yourself. And Terry Bradshaw says, love yourself. He said, you got to love yourself. You got to love yourself so that you can do the things that you want to do. Mm-hmm. And he says, if you're good with that, then you're fine. But Steve says, be kind to yourself. And he says, when sharing kindness, it's not just how you treat other people. It's also about how you extend those same behaviors and intentions to yourself. Mm-hmm. He says, I believe you can be kinder in your own self-talk and practice gratitude.
That's a good point.
It is. He says, people are good at verbally beating themselves up, which does not work as a pep talk. Rather, negativity often causes you to unravel and may even create a vicious cycle of regularly getting down on yourself. He says, you wouldn't talk to your neighbor that way. You sometimes speak to yourself. So this is what I call the good neighbor policy, which can be helpful. If you wouldn't say it to your neighbor, to your good neighbor, then don't say it about yourself.
I like that.
I like it too. And my mom always said, if you don't have anything good to say about somebody, don't say it at all.
I think moms were required to say that in their generation.
I think my mom had many, 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 many degrees, but she just never boasted about them. But I think she was a psychiatrist, a psychologist. She was a doctor. I know she was a doctor because she fixed all my boo-boos.
Gosh, that's great.
Steve says also to take action. And he says, start your day with this question. And I'm going to have this question for everyone else. But he says, start your day with, how am I going to practice kindness today? And I thought, how cool is that?
Yes.
How am I going to practice kindness today? So what do I do? I don't know. He says, for a homework assignment, I have invited some participants to pay attention and periodically document their evidence of kindness to others and especially to themselves during the day. He says, this positive focus is like planting positive seeds in your mind garden. I like that, the mind garden.
Yes.
Where focus goes, energy flows.
That sounds like a Zig Ziglar saying.
It was such a fun article to read. And I thought, I'm laughing and smiling now. I just can't get over it. It's just one random act of kindness. Just, you know, the art of kindness. I really enjoy that. So what do you have for us now?
Oh, this is going to be so fun, because I was, again, this is a headline that I landed on and spent a little more time with. And it is, what do you have to offer the world? That was the headline. And then the line underneath that was, the world needs people who want to give the best they have to offer. And when you think about your day-to-day purpose, it isn't the huge Elon Musk kind of life changes. Mm. It can be being kind to a stranger, giving a hug, the little seeds. They even talked about planting seeds. And you, as you had said, planting the seeds of kindness. One step at a time makes a big impact. And I thought of a case of a friend's mother that really reminded me of this. Her husband had an important public position for most of his career, and he had a huge personality, and she was very quiet, and you could see where maybe she would get overlooked. But at her funeral many years ago, or a couple years ago, when the audience was asked, how many of you received a thank you card in your lifetime from our mother, over 100 people there raised their hands.
Wow.
And it turns out she was the queen of thank you notes. She that was her little way of impacting the world. And one card at a time, she made a huge impact, such that it was everybody in the church was bonded with one another because they had been on her received list. So
excellent.
Yeah.
That's very cool. That is very cool.
And flows perfectly with what you're saying here.
Well, so now I hope you can see, I hope you notice that I never got to the professional side of Offer.
You did not.
I did not, because I went down this personal side and found this article and just was so enthralled with it.
Yeah.
Right? Yes. And so, you know, maybe that's another podcast for another day, the professional side of Offer. But I do have a challenge for individuals.
Let's hear it.
The same one that Steve suggested. So today I'm going to ask you, to the listening audience, ask yourself this: how am I going to practice kindness today? And I'll start by saying, I made an offer, and the offer was accepted. I'm going to go to an organization, and over an 8-week period, 1 hour every 1 hour a day, not, I'm sorry, every Tuesday, for 1 hour for 8 weeks, I'm going to go and do some leadership development for them, and I'm not charging them a dime.
That's very kind.
It's just a kindness, because one, the person who asked me if I could do it is a friend of, that'd be you, Sheila.
Thank you, Wayne.
And I said, since you're a friend of Sheila, I can do this. If you guys accept, I will do it for free. And they accept it. So that's how I'm going to do my practice kindness today. I'm giving up 8 weeks of my time, 8 hours to do that. And it's no big deal, because I like what I do. I like myself. And you know what? They get my A game.
And it is so you to do a great job in that arena too. And so the question I again read, the headline was, the world needs people who want to give the best they have to offer. So thank you, Wayne.
Well, thank you. And I'm looking at the clock, and it is 27 minutes right now.
We thank everybody for listening to us. Please follow or subscribe on whatever listening platform you use, and have a great week.
And have a good day, and do some kindness, some random acts of kindness out there. Thanks for listening, everyone. Thank you, Sheila.
Thank you, Wayne.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.